First, we give honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the one who is head of our life. We're just so grateful for another day, another chance, another opportunity that He has given us as we live, move, and have our being to be about His business. We can truly say that the Lord has blessed us, He has enabled us to live, move, and have our being all of these many years. And we can truly say, not because of no merits, but because of His grace, He sees fit to allow our golden moment to roll on up to this present moment. And we can't help but just giving Him all that honor and the praise. At this particular time, we want to just have a word of prayer. Let us pray. Our Father, Father in heaven, it's another day. You have blessed us. You have been there all the time, for you told us that you will never leave us, neither you forsake us, but you be with us even until the end of the world. And we know you are able to keep your word, for you the author and the finish of our faith, and we see ourselves as helpless people without you. But Lord, with you all things are possible to those that believe. And I can truly say today, I believe. I believe thou art the Christ, the Son of a living God. I believe you got all power trusted in your hands. I believe you can do exactly what you promised to do. And as we enter into your word, ask the Lord to give me the wisdom, the knowledge, the understanding I need that I may be able to come forth and bring forth your truths. For it in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen. God bless you. For our lesson today, our message today, coming out of the book of 1 Corinthians, the 4th chapter. 4th chapter and the 1st verse to the 18th verse. Then we're going to the 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter, first, and I think we just stop at the 10th verse. And today, our subject today, God's sustaining grace, give us the power to never give up.
Amen.
Amen. He let us to know that we're going to have some trials. We're going to have some tribulation, but by Him being who He are and what He have invested in earthly vessels, we do not have to give up. We can put all of our faith in Him. He let us to know, amen, God has a purpose for allowing us to suffer for His name's sake. We must know. We must know. Amen. We are no longer our own. We are bought with a price. And all the suffering that we go through, God's grace is enough to sustain us in all things that come against us. It never God will that any of us would perish. He tell us, amen, give us the power to never give up. God prepared us through the thing that we suffer for His name's sake. Paul said, when I am weak, then I'm strong.
Amen.
God is able to do these things. He the author and the finisher of our faith. Amen. I can't give up now because I've come too far. I have come too far, amen, leaning and depending on our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He is able to do what no other power can do. We are ready now to go to our lesson for today. Then look at the book. Amen. 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter, and the 1st verse. It reads as follows. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry. Maybe I need to pause here for a moment. What ministry? The ministry that God gave to Apostle Paul to bring forth for the age of the church, what we call the body of Christ. He had given us this ministry, amen, that we may be able to carry out God's will. Let me go back over it again. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, amen. God is the merciful God. Amen. The thing that we have to faith, amen, he has given us the mercy. He's been a merciful God. Amen. So we faint not. Amen. If it wasn't for the Lord on our side, oh, how helpless we would be. The Bible tells us, and we move on down to this second verse here, but have renowned the hidden thing of dishonest. Amen. Not walking in craftiness. We don't walk that way no more. We used to walk that way, but when you become a new creation and the Holy Spirit takes his abode in us, we don't walk in craftiness, nor hallow the word of God in deceitfulness. Amen. But by manifestation, amen, of the truth, commending ourselves to every man conscious in the sight of God. It's all about him. Amen. We have to recognize it ain't about us. It ain't about me. But it's about what he is able to do. He is able because the work that he wrought on the cross of Calvary. Then he was able then to come and the Holy Ghost would take his abode in us, that we may be able, that the Holy Ghost would teach us God's word. Did you know, sister and brother, no man, woman, boy, or girl could ever know anything concerning this book without the ministry of the Holy Ghost leading and guiding us into all truth? Amen. The Bible tells us, as we move on down to the third verse here, amen. But if the gospel, amen, be hid, it is hid to them that are lost. Who is that which is lost? The one who will not accept Jesus Christ's death, burial, and his resurrection. Amen. And at the same time, it not God's will that any would perish. If a man perish, he will perish because of his own unbelief. The work is already done. When Jesus died on the cross, he died for the sin of the whole entire world. And there one way to miss, amen, to miss out on God's will and God's plan is to not to accept. And there are going to be many that live in this life, long life, and yet wouldn't accept Jesus Christ. Amen. And the Bible tells us God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believe on him shall not perish but have everlasting life. But mankind will miss the mark because of unbelief. Let's move on down to this fourth verse here. In whom the God of this world. Amen. This is the reason why they will not accept Jesus Christ. Amen. Because of the God of this world have blinded the mind of them which believe not. Amen. Lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, shine, amen, should shine into them. Everything need to be done, he have already done it. And all we have to do is accept Amen. This eternal life. Because the Bible tells us it isn't about us. It isn't about me. How you know that, Atkin? Let's go down to this fifth verse. It spells it out. For we preach not ourselves. Amen. It ain't about us, sisters and brothers. It's about Him. Amen. But Christ Jesus, the Lord, and ourselves, your servant for Jesus' sake. Amen, sister and brother. We have a place, and God has a place. And we have to stay in our own order. Amen. And let God have His way in our life. And we move on down to the sixth verse here. For God have commanded the light to shine out of darkness, have shined in our heart. This is talking about this one group. Who is this group he talking about? He talking about those who have accepted Jesus Christ for their personal Savior. The one who have confessed with the mouth and believed in the heart that it was God raised Jesus from the dead. This the group he talking about. Amen. Then he went on and said, to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God, amen, in the face of Jesus Christ. Everything that need to be done, He have already done it. Amen. And sister and brother, the Bible said God so loved the world, He loved us so well that He died on the cross of Calvary. And then He went on to glory. And then what happened? He sent the Holy Ghost down. And the Holy Ghost had took His abode in us. Amen. And opened up our spiritual understanding. And that don't have nothing to do with natural ability. How you know that, Atkin? The natural man know not the things of God. Neither can they know them because they are spiritual discerned. If I'm going to get it, I'm going to get it God's way. The Bible tells us, and we move on down to this seventh verse. But we have this treasure. Amen. Talking about this heavenly treasure. Amen. We have this heavenly treasure, sister and brother, in earthly vessels. God have ordained it. Amen. That the excellence of the power may be of God and not of us. Amen. I have nothing to boast off of, but boasting off in the Lord. He the one. He the only one. And He let us know as a believer, don't you think that because we are saved that we will walk through here on the flower bread of Eve? Amen. Because this book is dealing with saved peoples. It's telling us the thing that we have to face down here. As I look at this 8th verse, amen, and read like this. For we are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed. We are puzzled sometimes. Amen. This is what the Bible telling us. Amen, sister and brother. But not in despair. Amen. Why is this? Because of what Jesus has invested in earthly vessels. We're able to go through the thing that we must face. The Bible tells us what will happen as a believer, because this ain't talking about nobody lost here. He talking about those who are saved. That ninth verse, persecuted. Amen. But not forsaken. Amen. Jesus will be with you every step of the way. Cast down, but not destroyed. Amen. You can't be defeated when you have made Jesus your choice.
Amen.
He the author and the finisher of our faith. And we can lean on Him when we're not strong. Yes, there is some thing that we have to face. We have to face some thing, but the sustaining grace give us the power to go on through. Amen. The Bible tells us, as we move on down to this 10th verse here, amen, always bearing about the body of the dying of our Lord Jesus, that the life also of Christ might be made manifest, might be made known. Amen, sister and brother, in our body. Oh, I hope we see this. We won't bone the first birth of this. This is something brand new. And it didn't come until Jesus died on the cross of Calvary. Then he sent the Holy Spirit down to lead, to guide us into all truths. Let's go on down to this 11th verse here. Amen. For we which live are always, amen, always delivered into death for Jesus' sake. Amen, sister and brother. Talking about the believer right on. Amen. That the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our mortal body. Amen, sister and brother. With all of these things that are coming, Jesus is able to give us joy in the mix of the trials, in the mix of the tribulation, the thing that we have to face, because he has told us, I will never leave you, neither I forsake you, but I'll be with you even until the end of the world. He is able to do so. He's the author and the finisher of our faith. Let's move on down to this script verse here. Amen. So then death worketh in us. Talk about the believers. Amen. But life in you. Amen, sister and brother. The you he talking about is those who have made Jesus their choice. Amen. We have the same spirit of faith according as it is written. I believe and therefore have I spoken. Amen. We also believe and therefore speak. We speak the truth. The truth will do something for you. And we can only know truth by the person of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. What he have invested in earthen vessels. Amen. I'm not talking about somebody just a member of a local assembly. For I can be a member of a local assembly and still lost. But I cannot know Jesus and be lost. He the author and the finisher of our faith. Let's go on down to this 14th verse. Knowing that he which raised up, amen, the Lord Jesus, shall raise up us also by Jesus, and shall present us with you. He bring us together. Together we stand, and divide, and we'll fall, sister and brother. And we are members of one another. Amen. All Christians and sisters and brothers, regardless of creed or color. Amen. When we accept Jesus Christ, we become, amen, sisters and brothers to all that believe. The finished work. Let's move on down to this 15th verse. For all things are for your sake. Amen. That the abundance of grace may through the thanksgiving of giving of many renown to the glory of God. Amen. Sisters and brothers, he has fixed everything that need to be fixed. He is the author. He is the finisher. Amen. And it gives us the power. Power to do what? Amen. Look what this 16th verse said. For which cause we faint not. Amen. He give us the grace. He give us what it take to go through, to not to faint. But through our outward man perish. Talking about this old physical body here. Amen. This old body can perish, sister and brother. But the Bible said, yet the inward man is renewed. Amen. How is the inward man renewed? Amen. Week after week, day after day. No, amen, sister and brother. It is renewed day by day. That's what the Bible say. We have to take God at His word. Amen. This why we can go through it so much. That's why we can go through it so much, sister and brother, because God have renewed us day by day. And we look at this 17th verse here. Amen, sister and brother. He said, amen, for our light affliction. Talking about the thing that will face us on the face of this earth. Amen, sister and brother. Which is but for a moment. In God our sight. It's just for a moment, sister and brother, the thing that we have to face. Amen. And the Bible said, it worketh for us. Amen. A far more exceedingly and eternal weight of glory. He have did it. We owe Him a praise. Everything that need to be done, He have already done it, sister and brother. Have equipped us with this great power. This power that come from above. The Bible tell us, and we look at this 18th verse here. Amen. While we look not at the things which are seen. Amen. Thing that we are seen, sister and brother, is not your thing. Amen. But the things which are not seen. Amen. For the things which are seen are temporal, just for a season. Amen. But the things which are not seen are eternal. Amen, sisters and brothers. We have a God, a Father, who have really did everything that need to be done for you and for me. Amen. He has given us this power in this earthly vessels. Amen. Let's go on down to this fifth verse here. Amen. Talk about those who have accepted Jesus Christ, what God has done for us. Amen. This is what this verse is talking about. Amen. What God has done for those who have made Jesus their choice. What God has done with this earthly vessel that we are tabernacling in. Listen what the word tell us. For we know. Amen. That if our earthly house of this tabernacle. Amen. Were dissolved. We have a building of God. Amen. A house not made with hand, eternal in the heaven. We have something far better than where we at today. Amen, sisters and brothers. We have what God have ordained for us. Amen. This thing is eternal. Amen. This new life is eternal. And we move on down to this second verse. For in this we groan. Talking about in this earthly vessel that we living in now. We have the ups. We have the downs. We have the crying. We have the tribulation, sister and brother. We groan. The Bible says earnestly. designed to be clothed upon with our house, amen, which is from heaven. Amen. This new house that he have already gone away and prepared for you and me. A brand new body. Amen, sisters and brothers. He have prepared it for every man that will believe in the finished work of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. If so be, the third verse, so be, amen, be that being clothed, we shall not be found naked. We are clothed with the righteousness of God. Amen. When we accept him, we have the righteousness of God, sister and brother, and that's what carries us through. That's why we can go through with some heartaches, some crying, some tribulations, some ups and downs. Amen. The Bible tells us, every move on down to this fourth verse here, for we that are in this tabernacle, talking about this old physical body here, amen. He tell us, amen, we do groan, being burned, amen. Not for that we should be unclothed, but clothed upon the mortality might be swallowed up, amen, of life. Talking about this new man that Jesus has wrought in order for us to make this journey. Amen. A part of us, sister and brother, can't make this journey. This earthly vessel ain't going nowhere. It's going to be a brand new body, lacking into his body when he got up, amen, out of the grave. We gonna be just like him. We ought to tell him thank you. Thank you, Lord, for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you, Lord, for who you are and what you have done in earthly vessels. You did it. Amen. Not we ourselves, but you loved us so well. You prepared the way for all mankind. And if not God will for any to perish, amen. But if we don't accept him, then, sister and brother, we will perish. But if you know who Jesus is, if you know him, amen, for your personal Savior, he'll make a way for you. Let's go on down to this fifth verse here. Amen. Now he that have wrought us for the self same thing is God. Amen. Don't you see? He have fixed everything that need to be fixed. Amen. Who have given unto us, amen, us the earnest of his the Spirit. What Spirit? The Holy Spirit. Amen, sister and brother. We can't help but just giving him all the honor. He has given us everything. He has given us the Holy Spirit. Amen. Well, where the Holy Spirit at? Unseen. You can't see it. But he has took his abode in every believer. Amen. And what did he do? He lead. Talking about the Holy Ghost. He lead and guide us into all true, sister and brother. The work of the Holy Spirit do the work. Amen. We can't do it without him. It's all about him. So we ought to tell him thank you. Let's move on down to this sixth verse here. Amen. Therefore, we are always confident, knowing that while, amen, we are at home in the body, talking about this old earthly body here now, we are absent from the Lord. I hope we see these truths, sisters and brothers. Amen. But what we know is coming. We know because of faith, sister and brother. The Bible said, for we walk by faith and not by sight. Amen. This is talking about the new man. Ain't talking about this old physical body. Sister and brother, the Bible said, we are confidence. God give us the power to be confidence. I say and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. Amen, sister and brother. He's talking to those who have accepted Jesus Christ for their personal Savior. We ain't home yet. Amen. No believer is home yet, sister and brother. Amen. But he got a time set. He got a time set. The Bible tells us as we move on down through this ninth verse here. Amen. Wherefore we labor. Amen. We continue to work, sister and brother. That whether, amen, present or absent, amen, we may be accepted of him. Amen. We ain't there yet, but we are accepted of him because we have believed in the finished work of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. He have already done it. Amen, sister and brothers. And we move on down to this 10th verse. For we must all. Maybe I need to pause here. Is he really talking about everybody? No. Amen. He talking about those who have accepted Jesus Christ for his personal Savior. Amen. For we all must appear before the judgment seat of Christ. The Bible said that everyone may receive the thing done in his body according to, amen, to that he had done, whether it's good or bad. Amen. God has a plan, and everything that needs to be done, he have already done it. He let us to know that these events that gonna come, sisters and brothers, he let us to know that, and we move on down to this 11th verse here. Knowing therefore that the terrors of the Lord, we persuade men, but we are made manifest. We are made known unto God, and our trust also are made manifest. Amen. In your conscience. The Bible tells us, for we commend not ourselves, amen, again into you, but give you occasion, amen, to glory on our behalf, that ye may have somewhat to answer them, amen, which glory in the presence, amen, and not at heart. Though that we can recognize and looking at, thinking about the flesh, we are to talk to them and let them to know, amen, that won't work. And let them know that it didn't work with us. Then let them to know, amen, and it will not work for them. Amen. We have this earthly vessels on the inside open up these understanding to us. Amen. This late verse here said, for whether we be beside ourselves, it is to God. Or whether we be sober, it is for your cause. Amen. This last verse here, for the love of Christ sustaineth us. Amen, because we thus judge that if one died for all, talking about who? Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ died for all, then we're all dead. Amen. I got to get this next verse here. Amen. And that he died for all. Talking about who? Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that they which live shall not, amen, henceforth live unto themselves, but into him which died for them, amen, and rose again. He did the work. The work has been already done. Our job is to accept the offer. What is the offer? He is offering eternal and everlasting life. Who is he offering it to? He is offering it to all mankind. Amen. And all we have to do is come confessing with the mouth, believing in the heart that if God raised Jesus from the dead, the same shall be saved. God bless you. God bless you. Don't clock on the wall. Don't clock on the wall. And then that can know. Time for me to get out of here. But if you is enjoying this radio program, will you write me a letter sometime? Walter Atkins Jr., Post Office Box 1142, Tarbert, North Carolina. This is Walter Atkins Jr. saying amen and amen.